He's an excellent technician. He has two quads in his repertoire and a beautiful triple axle that you'll see this evening. Nobody spins faster in the air than Alexei. His teammate, Viktor Petrenko, was last year's world silver medalist. He's had a very difficult year. He's had boot problems. He's been through four different pairs of skates. Finally, out of desperation, he's wearing an old skate on his takeoff foot and a new skate on his landing foot for support. Viktor Petrenko is the only man in this event who has ever stood on the Olympic podium. He was third in 88. It's been a long wait for him to get to the top, and he's hoping that this competition will end that wait.
I'm picking up good vibrations. She's giving me the excitations.
When Viktor Petrenko needs to relax, he hits the beach. And he needed a lot of relaxing this past summer along the Black Sea, his hometown of Odessa. The Soviet Union never won a gold medal in men's figure skating. So now the pressure is on Viktor to begin a new era for the unified team.
I think it's really important for me, but I try to don't think about it. If I will all the time think you're gonna win, and I don't think it will help me.
Everyone likes Viktor. Everyone finds him charming and admires his stylish skating. And yet, everyone wonders, what will it take for this 22-year-old to finally claim the title as best in the world?
I have to do all my programs very clean. And I think the people who watch me will happy to see my skating, because I don't think it's too bad.
Big things have been predicted for Viktor ever since his surprising third place finish at the 88 Olympics. He probably gave his finest performance at the 91 World Championships, yet he still wound up second to Canada's Kurt Browning.
First of all, I was a little bit sad, and I think I did a very good job, but the judges chose the Kurt's program better. They find his program better than mine. It's fine, because, you know, it's a sport.
And although Viktor's being a sport about it, the results still hurt, especially since he received higher artistic marks than Browning. So what's a guy got to do to win this thing? He scoffs at talk that he can't skate more than classical routines.
If I will do just classical, they will say, oh, Petrenko just, he tried to do the classical style, that's it. He can do different, but I don't think they could tell about it now. I can do different styles now.
Round, round, get around, I get around, yeah, get around, round, round, I get around, I get around.
Skating is the main thing in Viktor's life, but a close second is his hometown of Odessa, a warm water port in the Ukraine.
It's not big city, it's small one. But people like to smiling a lot and joking. And I like to be here. I have friends here.
He's popular with other skaters, too, and counts Browning, Christopher Bowman, and Todd Eldridge among his best friends. Off the ice, that is. In Albertville, he's got an important point to make. No more runner-up. No more second fiddle.
How you think? What's better, gold or silver? I remember the last Olympics. It was very good, and I think this one is going to be better.
Viktor Petrenko will be skating a little bit later when we come back. The exciting young man from St. Petersburg, Alexei Ermanov. Back live on a Saturday night before a sellout crowd of nearly 12,000 at Pacific Center in Providence, Rhode Island, on the ice. Paul Wiley, Viktor Petrenko, gold and silver medalist in Albertville, France, in February of 1992. And down in the Kiss and Cry area, Tracy Wilson with Kurt Browning and Katarina Vick. Trace?
Thanks, Vern. Kurt, you've had a chance now to talk strategy with Viktor Petrenko. What's your plan of attack for this evening?
Well, actually, I think it sort of happened naturally. My triple axel's been on vacation, and Victor's is, like, here, really solid. So we're letting him push over the top with technical, and I'm trying a new program tonight that I hope will go for the artistic mark.
All right, Katarina, you're doing your Olympic long program. Is tonight going to be easier for you, or are you more nervous than in the technical program?
Well, I'm, of course, very nervous for tonight, but I just want to go out there and really skate well. It seems like a great audience, and we just want to go for it.
Okay, good luck to you both.
Thanks.
Vern?
All right, Trace, and the first on the ice, only an hour and a half away from his new home in the United States, that home in Simsbury, Connecticut. Viktor Petrenko is first.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome 1994 Olympic gold medalist Viktor Petrenko.
Viktor has chosen to skate his artistic program tonight to a traditional Spanish song, Malagueña, and it will be performed by one of the great Spanish artists, Plácido Domingo.
This program is billed as an artistic program, but Viktor has loaded this program with very difficult technical moves, and his opening one is the most difficult, triple axel. Beautiful triple axel double toe loop combination. Better than the two he did on Wednesday night. Most difficult jump to a triple axel is a triple lutz. It's coming right here. He'll vault with his right foot, and he doubles it. It's a little bit rushed. Safely. This particular portion of the competition is being held in theatrical lighting. Viktor was a little concerned about this, so the next two jumps could be doubles. The first one he's planned is a triple flip. Triple flip, a little two-foot, a little turnout. It'll be interesting to see if he now does the triple loop. Tilt it out again.
Gives her approval. His wife, Nina, is also here, as, of course, is his coach and mother-in-law, Galina Smievskaya. They're all part of Team Ukraine now, located about an hour and a half just outside of Hartford, Connecticut, in Simsbury, where a brand-new ice skating center has been built. Not only Viktor and Nina Petrenko and Oksana Bayul, but Katerina and Sergei Gordieva and Grinko over there as well.
Opening jump always sets the pace. Triple axel, look at the height. Huge, better than both the ones he did in the technical program. Double toe loop to cap it off. Little teammate praying there, and please, 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 yes! Always makes things a little bit easier when your teammate's skating so well.
Viktor has completed his task for the event. Let's go down to Pat O'Brien right quick.
All right, Vern, thank you. We're down here with Christy Yamaguchi and Nancy Kerrigan. I'm wondering, you guys have all had such great Olympic performances. Do you get nervous here, and do you think expectations are maybe too high at an event like this?
Of course we get nervous. For every time we step out on the ice in front of a crowd, there's always that something inside of you going, okay, skate well. But, you know, we want to go out there and show them, okay, I'm an Olympic champion, Olympic medalist, and give them what they want.
That's a good point, because you want to prove yourself all the time, right, on the ice?
Definitely. That's the reason why we train so much. It's not just for the audience, though, but for ourselves as well, and to prove to ourselves, you know, what we can do. And it's great that we can show it to everybody else.
You guys are in a good mood tonight. We'll be watching. See you.
He's an Olympic gold medalist. From Ukraine, Viktor Petrenko.
And this music, you don't have to think long about. It's called Too Sexy.
The 1992 Olympic gold medalist, Viktor Petrenko.
I'm too sexy for my love, too sexy for my love. Love's going to leave.
Well, he moved from Las Vegas to Connecticut, but
he's still got some Vegas in him.
I think a lot. You can take the boy out of the town, but you can't take the town out of the boy.
Oh, my shirt's too sexy, yeah.
The Chippendales were going to show up tonight, did you?
No. Well, he's going to be very busy in July. He and his wife are going to expect their first baby.
He lives and trains in Simsbury, Connecticut now, and he's brought this crowd out of their seats as well. Viktor Petrenko.